пир. Называется здесь вот паркуются яхты. Так, мы сегодня едем архитектурный тур. Это почти как архитектурный тур. Вот на лодке вот мы такой. Даже вот пристегнуться нам сказали вот. Как в самолете.
Clock Extreme Thrill Ride. No. Not the Odyssey no, Dinner Cruise. No. Not the opening spin of the Centennial Wheel. Alright, we still have ways than that. So do not do that. We do have a restroom on the boat. So let me just give you some advice, give you tons of advice today. We have sunk hundreds of millions of dollars into that pier. The restrooms are awfully nice. We've got a nice closet bath, especially when we are on the leg portion of this tour. I am cuss man in. Your name gets changed if there's too many of one person or name in a company, so they gave me that name because I studied education, trying to become a teacher, and I like to do this during the summer. It's kind of like a floating classroom. It's enjoyable. So that's my name here, a shocker. Better have plenty of, get some mobile charges for the iPad or something like that. Well, welcome from, they're in the Chicago Harbor Lock. You can see here the front doors are opening ever so slow. Buzz Tower, we'll peek around a little bit, we'll turn around, we'll come back out to Lake Michigan, have a nice little cruise on the lakefront before we send you guys on your way again. It was destroyed. Chicago did a number of things. For one thing, well, they established no wake zones. And to our right, these people didn't get the hit. How under at least 16 bridges going down and back again. Now, all these bridges that you'll see today open and close, 37 movable bridges that span the Chicago River. Prime example of what I was referring to just a few moments ago. Off to your left, this is Lakeshore East, one of the newer neighborhoods of the city. 140 years ago, very proud of her. Now, Aqua has its balcony shaped like that in order to give better views and maximize views to the tenants that live there. It's also meant to pay tribute to the environment surrounding it. When we talk about postmodernism and architecture, yeah. You'll see this here in just a few moments again. Off to your left. What is the thing? For 5 years, it was a little bit more anonymous. Then in the year 2014, the Donald had an idea going, you know, I'm going to mark up my property as mine. And that's a 3,000 square foot sign. As we go up and down this river today, look around to the fellow architecture and the fellow surrounding buildings. Do you see a Trump-sized sign anywhere else? Most likely you won't. Partially because of a law. After the Trump Tower sign was installed, Chicago said, no more of that. He legally did that, he got permission. He alters the nighttime skyline, alters the daytime skyline. What you need to know about this Trump Tower is it's our second tallest building in the city. It's 1,389 feet tall, designed by Chicago and Adrian Smith. It's okay, that sign does upset everybody, it's okay. It's okay, it's gonna be okay, we're gonna pass it. Designed by Chicago and Adrian Smith. 92 stories tall. It's a mixed-use building. The first floors are a luxury hotel. Then it goes into condominiums. And towards the top, you'll see four penthouses, four private penthouses with near 360-degree views, topped off by that several hundred-foot spire. A few notable people live here, including Patrick Kane, Derek Rose, Rex Grossman. Hey. He put in his time. He put in his surf. The Aeon, you'll see the Hancock. You won't see our Trump Tower. More on the Trump Tower as we come back. Directly next to our Trump Tower is the Wrigley Buildings. The Wrigley Towers dating to 1921 and 1924. Designed by Graham Anderson Probst and White. Take a close look at it. It almost kind of looks like a Lego structure because the buildings are clad in over 250,000 pieces of terracotta. It may look a little dirty to you, but that's not dirt. That's six different shades of white tile. It's supposed to intentionally mess with your eyes so that it draws your attention up to the clock tower at the very roof of that building, intentionally done to do so. Here's that remarkable, lovely building and sign. Remember I said for 5 years, this tower had no Trump stamp on it. However, one day, these letters started going up one day at a time. One day it was the T Tower, then it was the TR Tower, then the True Tower, the Trump Tower, and then finally the Trump Tower is complete. City ordinance saying no more of that after we have that. See the sun glistening off the buildings, for example. You get a great shot here of Chicago's Marina City, Marina 1 and Marina 2, completed in the 60s, designed by Bertrand Goldberg. Now, Marina City 1 and Marina City 2 are these two conical, these two cylindrical towers going well over 60 stories into the air. They're designed to be a city within a city. Because in the 50s and 60s, Chicagoans were leaving the city. Interesting experiment, especially with this concept of the architecture, where each of these buildings, if you were to take off its outside structure, would look like an empty roll of paper towels. And when you look, now the heat's broken a little bit, it's getting a little bit cooler as the sun disappears and the nighttime air starts to settle in here over Chicago. If you guys are looking for something to do, something I can't recommend enough is taking a walk on our Chicago River Walk over here to your left. Now, the River Walk itself starts all the way down by the pier, and eventually when it's completed by 2017, it's going to go all the way down to the bend of the river, and it'll be a nice maybe mile and a quarter mile stretch along the river here. Entirely free for you to come and just take an interesting vantage point of the city, have some people we're doing their business into, and then they're going home for the end of the day. Now, however, the Chicago River is in transformation. This is an example of environmentally friendly architecture, Leeds style of architecture. When the air conditioning goes on in this place, they start sucking river water out of the river. They filter it through the building, it cools off the building, cleans up the water, goes back into the river system cleaner than it found it, at a significant savings in energy costs, especially cooling costs for that building. So even though that the Chicago River was once a place that you really wanted to avoid at all costs, these days, it's a river in reverse. Well, because of the sun coming to your eyes. So we'll talk about the merchandise mart as we're coming back down from the opposite direction of the river. If you take a look to your left, here's the latest sections of the Riverwalk under construction right now. They're literally moving out into the river, digging. How nice of a place to take a boat ride. These days, though, it's getting cleaned up. We have these kayaking groups come through. We've got these modern-day jet ski cowboys that tries to round up these groups and keep them in order. It's pretty entertaining to watch, unless they get in the way, of course. Directly in front of us, that is River Place. It's almost complete. About to open soon. That will be entirely office space. Even though that we're at risk of losing our title of third largest city in the country to Houston, they are still building more apartments and condos than ever before in the city. So please, if you like it here today, come down. Directly next door to River Place, you have 150 North Riverside Plaza, designed by Getch Architects. Interestingly enough, this is done in a cantilevered fashion, where if you look at the building, it tapers outward the taller it gets, with a very narrow relative base supporting that entire structure. Now, why is that? Not only just for down to other states and communities that share that river on its way down to the Gulf of Mexico. Off to your left, now you see the Civic Opera Building. coming into view now. Opened in 1930, done in an Art Deco style. A few great examples, especially later in the tour. These buildings are symmetrical, they taper inward, the taller they get, and in several of these cases, money for it. The reason it's shaped the way it is because when this was completed in 1930, this was a major structure. This was a majorly tall building. They were afraid that it was going to block out the view of the sky and also the daytime lighting for several buildings around it. And also, remember, air conditioning is a modern phenomenon. When you shape your buildings like this, it's supposed to encourage and increase airflow as well. Specific reasons. Across the way here, 2 North Riverside Plaza, the same type of concept, kind of a throne design to the building. Employ what's called air rights construction. You can see this air rights construction in practice. So long as you do not block the railroad tracks, you are welcome to build in the sky above them. Here's another great example of a style of architecture known as the International Style of Architecture, Gateway 1 and Gateway 2, designed by Bruce Graham, remember that name? Now, in the International Style of Architecture, designing architects, so much so that this international style of building buildings went into our tallest building here in the city of Chicago, a building with an identity crisis. It's worth $1.3 billion, but for such a pricey property, we cannot tell you what its name is. If you're here in Chicago visiting, heck if you're here, it's 110 stories tall. You'll see here, off to your left, you're going to want to kind of bring your neck up. You might think to yourself, Michael, that doesn't look like a simple box. That doesn't look like international style. And I'm going to tell you, there's 9 different boxes here. 9 different modules, all banded together. That is how you build a building 1,451 feet tall. That is how you build a building that's not going to collapse under strong winds up at the very top of that building. It could be like maybe 10 miles an hour in terms of a current down here at street level. Up there, that could be hurricane force winds. That building actually sways in the breeze. If you go up to the ledge experience, if you go up to the observation deck, you can see the water in sinks and toilets swishing around because the building is actually shaking on its foundation. It's meant to do that. You guys can see that coming into view here. Now we're going to take a little turn. Head back up north. And 4 million square feet of asbestos as well. So unless you guys want that free gift, it's going to take a while until that building is put into action. Should be pretty cool though. You can see the Sears/Willis/Blackstone Tower coming into view again. Take a look how it tapers off like that. It's 9 different structures all make people happy or they go off to somebody else and do their work for them instead. One of the ways you can make people happy is when you serrate corners in a building. Take a look over here at the former Mercantile Exchange Center to your right. If you look at the corners of these towers, these serrated corners are able to take 4 corner offices and turn them into 16 corner offices. Kind of diminishes the value a little bit, but it's able to keep some of those star employees a little bit happier than perhaps they would have been. Plaza. This opened up in the 30s. Now, the Depression hit, they ran out of money. The rumor was there was supposed to be a head at the very top of the structure resembling of a Sphinx in Egypt, and it was paused. But again, they ran out of cash. Instead, you're just left this symmetrical Art Deco building going on over here. Again, built over air rights construction. Especially if you own property in this city. For example, 150 North Riverside Plaza. Remember the cantilevered structure here, meaning the narrow base of the building goes taller and wider as the building expands into the sky. Great for 150 North Riverside Plaza, bad news for River Center 1 directly behind it. Now River Center 1, geez, 108 years ago or so, it's owned by the Kennedy family, the famous political dynasty from America, and eventually they're going to completely cover this little strip of land of at least 2 more towers, completely blocking out the Sun Times as behind them. No hard feelings towards $1 million. They held on to it for about 50 years or so, and they turned that original investment into a sale of $575 million, selling off their stake in Chicago's Merchandise Mart. A structure that's done in the Art Deco style that takes up 2 entire city blocks, the second largest building in the world after only the Pentagon, had its own zip code for 60...
How much was Daniel made?
So again, here in Chicago, Things are for sale. If you have money, you can get things done, especially if you find that right price for what people are looking for.
Oh man, those kayakers.
That could feel good, it could feel bad.
I don't know.
When they started that project, it was the year 1889. Now, this isn't the extreme ride, and I don't know, sometimes depending on your captain, they love to just get the tip of the bow into the stream and everybody else is just laughing at me. And I'm thinking, it's like, I'm holding an electrified microphone. Why are you doing this? Let me tell you what people do with it. Incredibly popular place to come on your wedding day, to come for proms, come on dates, have pictures taken. Most people don't know their history, though. They don't know the moments before we get out of here. My voice is starting to betray me. Before my voice completely bites the bullet, are there any other questions? What we saw, things I didn't cover, things about the city you've heard. Yes, ma'am. The Chicago flag, is there a good... Okay, take a look over the... This is where the Navy was training people to take off and land from aircraft carriers. They were doing that after they only had 3 days of training. Now think about it, you get in a class and for 3 days, then you have to take off and land an airplane on a moving surface. A lot of airplanes still at the bottom of the slope. But that's why we call Navy here, Navy here, because of its contributions to the war effort. I hear one no and 99.999% yes. So hold on to your hat, stay seated, wear your seatbelts. Guys, enjoy. It's a beautiful Tuesday here in Chicago. We're happy you're here with us.
Красиво, как будто специально разукрасили полосами. Наперёк.